Hello, people. Today we're going to look at this Lionel H.O. 242 locomotive that I have. It's pretty strange. I just figured it'd be worth sharing since there are like zero videos I can find on the internet of it. There are images though, but no videos, so I figured I could be the first. So yeah, it's a very weird looking engine. It's very obviously one of Lionel's O-gauge offerings that have been scaled down into HO. And obviously with O, like toy scale already being very strange, this has resulted in this very just bizarre looking engine with these like incredibly tall wheels you can see. It's definitely charming, but it's pretty weird still. Like, when I first saw it at a train show, I was just like, what is this? Because, like, it's just so strange looking. But, yeah, it has a die-cast chassis, and right here, the cowcatcher in the front, along with the stairs, those are all die cast, and the rest of the body is just plastic. Now if I quickly remove the body, there we go, you can see that it is a rubber band driven locomotive, and this is honestly a shame to me because I like this engine quite a bit, but the problem with rubber band driven engines is that, you know, over time the rubber band is going to crack and eventually you're going to have to replace it, and some brands are more intuitive than others with how you put in the rubber bands, and I'd say Athearn is definitely better, but this, the way to remove this is very annoying, honestly. You have to go under here, remove the entire, you have to take off the wheels, the steam chests, and all the pickups, the front and back, the pony trucks and the trailing trucks. You have to remove all of that, and then, like, it's hard to visualize, but there's like a gear inside of there, and you have to put the rubber band around it, and then you have to stick it through this hole on the top, and then pull it through, and then stretch it over that black plastic piece attached to the motor, and it's very annoying. And so since rubber bands break very easily, you know, this engine, I only recently replaced the rubber band. It's probably only gonna run for like a week, 2 weeks maybe at the most, because the rubber bands just crack, at least the ones I'm using. Perhaps if I get a high quality rubber band drive or something like that, it would be better, but it would be hard to find one that would exactly fit this engine. But yeah, despite that, I do still like the engine quite a bit. Like I said, it's very charming. It runs pretty nicely too, and the detail isn't terrible for its age. I'm not exactly sure when Lionel H.O. Were being made. I think it was the 60s or the 50s. This does definitely have a 60s vibe to it, if you know what I mean, like 60s model railroading. It's very like, the rivets are usually like a giveaway for me because they're always very like pronounced and strange looking. But yeah, I guess enough blabbering, should run it. Okay, so now I just want to show the drive actually working. You see the band spins around and then it turns the gear that's inside the chassis around, causing the entire locomotive to move. And this thing is actually, I mean, I know this sounds a little silly, but it's kind of smooth. that's not good. For a rubber band drive, it is slipping a little bit just now. And also it has a three-pole motor. I forgot to mention that. Yeah, see, it's not too bad. For what it is, it's not too bad. So yeah, can I just take that guy on there? And pull this very short contest I have right here. There it goes. I went to increase the consist size, and as I was doing that, I got out the camera, I was going to start filming, and the rubber band has failed. So it hasn't snapped, but basically what happened, and this is more the rubber band's fault, not the engine, but the rubber band is slightly too large. So it was able to jump this lip down there. Because there's another one of these attached to the worm gears that drive these wheels. So the bottom side of the rubber band has jumped the lip. It is now here. And so now when it spins, it's creating virtually zero traction. So it basically just sits there and does nothing. So yeah, that kind of sucks. And also when I attempted to, because I took the engine apart, and because I wanted to try to re-rail the rubber band, and I did it, and I put it back on, and immediately jumped the lip again. But also the bottom plate, the wire broke, so I had to re-solder that, so... That was a lot of effort for pretty much nothing. I don't know. I don't want to keep the engine broken, but... Yeah, it kind of sucks. But it's a charming engine, and it's, like, an interesting-looking thing. But I don't think I could ever recommend anyone buying one of these. Unless you really like rubber band engines, Lionel, or just strange... 50s or 60s engines like I do. This is not a great locomotive. When it works, it's fun. When it doesn't work, it's very annoying and tedious to fix. So yeah. I'm not gonna try to fix this thing again because it's more trouble than it's worth. But yeah. Thank you for watching this epic vid. Maybe I'll make another one, or maybe I won't. I don't know. Bye.